Good evening, and welcome to the Holden Beach Chapel. We're glad that you have chosen to be with us this evening for this musical presentation. We hope that you will indeed experience the presence of God in this most wonderful time of the year. We're glad to see you. I'm a little bit curious here. How many of you are a part of the Holden Beach Chapel? You come here regularly or semi-regularly. Would you raise your hand, please? Wonderful. Now, how many of you, thank you, how many of you are visitors and you are not associated with the chapel at all? Well, welcome. We are glad to have you. We're glad to see you. And we're hopeful, once again, that you will enjoy this musical presentation. In the program, I failed to write in here that our narrators this evening will be Ann Landis and Bob Bayless. They are wonderful narrators, and you will enjoy their telling the story as we sing it. And also, I want to mention to you that toward the end of September, our choir and our church and our community experienced a considerable dear loss in the death of Jane Skubik. Of course, anytime we sing and dedicate our music in praise of God, and we dedicate it to His name, of course. But we remember Jane during this time because she would have been the first one here, and she would have been reaching out to you with her joy and her just spirit of life. And so we are saddened at her loss, but we are so thankful that we had the opportunity to know Jane and that our paths cross, and we know that we will see her again later. At this time, let's go to the Lord in prayer. It is the most wonderful time of the year, Lord, because we are joyful at the birth of your Son, Jesus Christ, and we know what that means for us all. We pray this evening that you would bless every individual, every family, every church, every community that's represented here this evening. And we pray that to the best that we are capable, that we praise your name and sing praises to you. Lord, for all we always do, we do it in service to you. In your name we pray, amen. Now, we're going to stand and sing the first and the last verses of hymn 103, O Come All You Faithful. Please stand as we sing two verses of O Come All You Faithful. Thank you.
Thank you. sky. How Jesus the Savior did come for to die for poor lowly people like you. Oh.
Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord rises on you. Darkness covers the earth, and thick darkness the people. But the Lord rises over you, and the Lord will be your eternal light.
Christmas comes in many ways, but it seems to always arrive first by starlight. God announces his advent with a tapestry of fire spread across the vast expanse of night. He sends his heavenly light through space to touch our dark earth, just as he came down from glory to live in our world. Emmanuel, God with us.
But how elusive a star can be, just like the seasons it represents. At times so radiant, you're sure to reach out and hold it in your hand forever. At times so distant, you blink and it seems to disappear. It's the same with Christmas. You can spend the whole year anticipating those magic feelings with hope to come with the holidays, only to watch them scatter and blow away with the strong gust of January wind.
No wonder we keep searching the skies, making a wish, saying a prayer, grabbing a star and placing it on top of our tree, hoping that this will be the year we'll find the way to make the light last a little longer, hoping that this will be the year we'll find Christmas and make it stay.
Together, we will be.
Have you ever wondered how Christmas got so preoccupied with what we don't have, but what we wish we did? Funny how things got so turned around somewhere along the line, but it doesn't seem to matter what age we are. Every December, we've got our noses pressed against that cold window pane, watching the sky, looking for, well, wishing for Christmas.
Thank you.
once a year, like clockwork it arrives. Ushered in by wintry winds, it graces all our lives.
A time that finds us slightly less demanding, and for a moment, a bit more understanding.
Freer with forgiveness, you're more inclined to smile. The simple truth of Jesus' birth warms me for a while.
And then December 26, it's gone.
Why can't the Christmas spirit last a little
tomorrow, not just Christmas Day? Have goodwill in September and peace on earth in May. Don't leave it at the manger. Just a star. Let Christmas come tomorrow. Keep Christmas in your heart. Let Christmas come tomorrow. Not just Christmas Day.
The same star we gaze at tonight once lit the Judean hillside and a desert road. They once lit temples and altars and prayerful hands raised to the evening sky.
The search for Christmas has been going on for thousands of years, ever since God first promised us that He would bring light into our dark world. With the birth of the Messiah.
Ancient prophets foretold the people walking in darkness would see a great light. and on those living in the land of the shadow of death, a great light would draw dawn.
A brilliant angel came to Mary and then to Joseph. "Fear not," the angel said. "Mary has found favor with God and will give birth to his son, and his name will be Jesus." They set out into the night to search for a distant city named Bethlehem. With no other light to guide them but their faith, they finally arrived and found shelter in a dark stable. That night, God's light entered our world forever.
Thank you.
has come.
Emmanuel is born.
Oh, glory in excess Deo. Emmanuel is born, and God orchestrated all the stars and moons and radiant legions of heaven to herald his coming. He then touched one particular star. He set it apart to shine over the cradle of his birth and to become a beacon into the strangely silent world.
Emmanuel is born, but where are those who promised to sing the Glorias? Where are those who professed to be waiting for his coming? The world seemed to take little notice, then or now. In spite of angelic thunder and blazing stars, we always seem to be looking somewhere else. No wonder we can't seem to find our way to that stable. Could we have already missed that star? Or have we just forgotten to look up?
There were three seekers from a distant land who did look up, who did see the first star. Instead of navigating by roads, they simply followed a light. Perhaps they can point the way for us. Thank you.
Each year, each Christmas, it always seems to come down to this scene, the Nativity, full of people who found their way to the manger with the help of heavenly light. Eventually, each of us must make our way to that manger, but alone, when the stable is empty, when there is only us and the child.
But our road is not as clearly lit as the one to Bethlehem. Angels don't come in the night to answer our questions, and stars seem remote, even cold. Some nights, you can't see them at all.
Yeah.
The stable is empty now. There is only a cradle of straw and a baby. Draw close. There is no need to wander or search the skies any longer. The light of the world has come, and not because we sought him, but because he sought us.
When Jesus was born, he was laid within the wood of a common manger. When he died, he was nailed to the rough wood of a cross. But he defeated the darkness of this world, even the grave. He arose on high to eternal life. Then he turned and extended this life everlasting back to us.
And this is Christmas. This is what the world has been searching for. Not nostalgic memories or good feelings or even peace on earth, goodwill toward men. What we're searching for at Christmas is hope. And that hope is Bethlehem. Perhaps your life is as dark and worn as that stable long ago, but remember that this is where he chose to be born. There is nothing he desires more than to be born once again in you. Pray with me. O holy child of Bethlehem, descend to us, we pray. Cast out our sin and enter in. Be born in us today. We've heard the Christmas angels, the great glad tidings tell. So come to us, abide with us. We pray in the name of our Lord, Emmanuel.
I was a seeker for light in a dark world. I looked for truth, but settled for lies. I had been blinded. I couldn't see. Till the star in Bethlehem sky opened my eyes.